A Moving by Supergrass. Great song, some really good chords in this song. Very jazzy, almost got a lot of Sinatra vibe. I think I remember Gaz saying that once in an interview, that he was sort of feeling that sort of Sinatra sound when he was writing a song. So yeah, let's crack on. So the first chord is a sort of a D13 sort of chord, I think. It's D13 sus4, it says. So basically you want a bar from the A string all the way down to the top E string on the 5th fret, and then you want to put your ring finger on the 7th fret of the B string, and then your pinky finger on the 7th fret of the top E. And strum all those chords down. Two down strums, and then up, up, down, up. So up, down, down, up, down, up. Yeah, the right hand in this is really, really tricky, so you just gotta battle through it. So yeah, D13 sus4. And then you go to an E minor add 9 sort of chord, so you keep those ring finger and pinky finger on the same frets, and you just bring up that middle finger to the E note, so that's the 7th fret on the A string. And it's keeping out that ringing G string, open G string. And then Gaz does something really cool here. He does like a G shape, if you imagine your G shape down there. He does it up there, so you're on that E minor add 9 chord. Move your ring finger and pinky finger up one fret to the 8th fret, and then put the G shape. So you want to keep that E note, so 7th fret, but now with your pointer finger, and then put your middle finger on the 8th fret of the bottom E. So G shape, normally down there, just up there on the 8th fret. So got this, the D13 sort of chord, E minor add 9, then that C, sort of a C add 9 chord. And then we go down to a nice easy chord, so we go A minor 7, which is first finger on the B string 1st fret, and middle finger on the D string 2nd fret. And then we do a B7 sus 2, which is basically barring that 2nd fret and putting your ring finger on that 4th fret of the D string. And then you put your pinky on to make it the B7 onto the 4th fret of the B string. So those last three chords, the A minor 7. And then you play it all around again, so it goes to the D again. B7 going into the chorus part. And so for the chorus part, we're playing our sort of normal bar chords. So you're up on the 7th fret B minor, so bar that 7th fret, and then put your ring finger and pinky on the 8th fret of the A string and the D string, and want to do two chugs down and then whack the whole chord. So all downstrokes. Same thing on the A chord, just on the fifth fret, A bar chord. Two down, one whole whack, two down, one whole whack. And then we're doing a cool little riff, which Gaz likes to do in a few different songs. A chord or riff, a bit Hendrix-y, it's like... So you're doing an a sort of E minor 7 chord, so you're barring on the 7th fret, and you're hammering on the chord shape, so you're hammering on with your middle finger onto the 8th fret, and with your ring finger onto the 9th fret of the D string. So hammer on, strum it, and then take it off and strum it again. Boom, bam, bam. So it's got that bounce to it. Twice. And then go back to the B. And then you go back to that B sus chord again. Then the B7. And then that's basically it. So you go back through the verses, and there's a solo as well, which is basically the melody, which Gaz is playing. I won't go through that today, but yeah, if you play through the rest of it, you've basically got the whole song. So yeah, good luck with it, guys.